Now you're listening to Live Interactive English. Pay attention, everybody! Hi, everyone. This is Karen.
Hello, everybody. I am Shane. Okay, today we're looking at part one of Rouen.
France's jewel on the Seine. And the vocabulary words are...Jewel.
Jewel.
The 16th century library is one of the jewels of the city.
Cultural.
Cultural.
Some people say that Montreal is the cultural center of Canada.
Major.
Major.
My grandfather was a major influence on me when I was growing up.
Me too.
Really?
Inn.
Inn.
Alex's aunt runs an inn in the countryside.
Cast. The fire cast an orange light on the walls of the cave. So we're talking about this beautiful place in France.
Rouen?
Is that
what you're talking about?
That's right.
Some people say it's a jewel.
Because it's so beautiful.
Because it's so beautiful.
They have
a really beautiful cathedral there that a very famous painter.
Claude Monet.
Yeah, right. So he did lots of pictures of the cathedral.
Cathedral paintings, that's right.
So that's, if you're an art fan, you will definitely recognize this beautiful city.
And you can also, where's that place where you can see, like, you know, half timber houses?
Oh, yeah, in the medieval quarter.
That's right.
Right.
And it's also filled with a lot of cafes and shops as well.
And if you like duck, they have a pretty famous duck there that you can try.
And the sauce is actually made from the duck's blood. It kind of sounds a little bit, but it's actually very delicious, so I've heard.
Because I'm a vegetarian.
Oh, that's right.
I don't want it. Oh, maybe I'll just skip that and I'll go see that really cool clock. It has two different clock faces.
Oh, that's also another important landmark.
Yeah, that one sounds really cool. And I've seen the pictures. It looks really pretty.
Oh, there's so many different places to see in this beautiful city, right?
That's very charming. Let's learn more.
All right.
Okay.
Rouen, France's jewel on the Seine. Located not far from Paris on the River Seine, the city of Rouen is a cultural jewel that is an important part of France's history.Rouen was a major trading center during Roman times and became the capital of Normandy in the 10th century, when it was one of the wealthiest cities in Europe. Controlled by the English through much of the Middle Ages, Rouen was where Joan of Arc was put to death and Impressionist painter Claude Monet created his Rouen Cathedral paintings.
Today's lesson is called Rouen, France's Jewel on the Seine.Part 1. Hello, everyone. My name is Jeff.
And I'm Mike. And yes, we're talking about the lovely country of France. And even better, we're not talking about Paris.
Yay!
Paris is great, don't get me wrong, but it gets a lot of the attention, right? When people think of France, all they think of is Paris. So let's leave Paris. Let's get out of the big city, go to a smaller town, which is just as good.Even more historic, possibly, and certainly has fewer tourists. We're talking about Rouen, one of the great cities of Normandy, over there in the western part of France. Not far from Paris. It's a good one-day trip, but you can definitely get away from Paris.
Okay, and notice that in the title, we're calling Rouen a jewel. Now, if we were being literal, a jewel is a precious stone.Diamonds, rubies, sapphires. Yes, you've probably seen a diamond ring before. That stone in there would be a jewel. Now, if a place is a jewel, though, what you're saying is that this thing is really, really nice. It's really, really good. It's a very positive thing to say about something. Further, sometimes you say that something is a hidden jewel, something that's really good, and you hadn't seen it before or noticed it before. And I guess...Like you said before, Paris gets more of the press. Rouen, though, is kind of a hidden jewel there in France. Anyways, for example, the 16th century library is one of the jewels of the city. Oh, it's just one of those great features of the city that that you might overlook, but which is super great and awesome.
Okay, so we might say like Taroko Gorge is a real jewel on the east coast of Taiwan.
You could say
that. It's great places to go, but Taroko with its amazing, you know, amazing views and wonderful geology, it's a real jewel. It's a really special place that you really don't want to miss. So let's find out about this jewel outside of Paris in France. It tells us exactly where we're going, located not far from Paris on the River Seine. The city of Rouen is a cultural jewel that is an important part of France's history. Absolutely. Many kings have spent time there, a lot of good history there. It's on the same river, the River Seine, that's the same one that goes through Paris, but it's a cultural jewel in France's history. When we talk about something cultural, this is an adjective relating to culture, sort of the history of a place, the songs, the food, the language, the religion, these things that we are interested when we travel. These are the cultural things, you know, when you go to another country and people have a different language, eat different food, wear different clothes, have different religions and beliefs and all that stuff. That's all culture. So anything about culture is cultural. If you're visiting a museum, there's a good chance you're visiting a museum to learn about cultural things. That's the kind of thing we often have in museums. And here's a sentence that's close to my heart. Some people say that Montreal is the cultural center of Canada.
Anyways, Rouen was a major trading center, get this, during Roman times, and became the capital of Normandy in the 10th century when it was one of the wealthiest cities in Europe. So at that point, it was a very wealthy city, and wow, its history as a trading center goes back a long, long ways, like thousands of years. That's how long we're talking about. So this is an old city and a very culturally significant city as well. Now, we're talking about culture. Let's also talk about how it was a major trading center. A lot of business was transacted in this particular place. And I know this because of the adjective major. If something is major, it's big. It's important. It's definitely not minor. Yes, the opposite of major is minor. Anyways, for example, my grandfather was a major influence on me when I was growing up. He was a big influence on me. He had a significant impact on my life. Anyways, now, Rouen is in France now. That wasn't always the case, though, was it?
Absolutely, yeah. Controlled by the English through much of the Middle Ages, Rouen was where Joan of Arc was put to death. And Impressionist painter Claude Monet created his Rouen Cathedral paintings. So there you go, some of the culture and history that's happened in this great city. Yeah, throughout the Middle Ages, the English controlled a lot of Normandy. They held Calais up until the 16th century. Ooh. But Rouen was also where Joan of Arc, the famous Joan of Arc in the Hundred Years' War, she was put to death by the English. And also many, many years later, in the 19th century, so not too long ago, the Impressionist painter Claude Monet created his Rouen Cathedral paintings there. So just giving you a little idea of some of the interesting history that's happened there over the last 1,000 years or so. And that takes us up to our break. So grab yourself a baguette, a little café au lait, and come back and join us for more from Rouen, the great city of Normandy.
After this.
One of them.
Hello, 大家好，我是 Hanny。这次要介绍的旅游景点是卢昂 Rouen。也许你没有听过这座城市，不过卢昂是圣女贞德被处死的地方，也是画家莫内他创作《卢昂大教堂》这幅画的所在地。那么课文写到，卢昂市它位在离巴黎不远的塞纳河岸，它是法国历史上重要的文化瑰宝。那在罗马时代呢，它是主要的贸易中心，然后在十世纪成为了诺曼底公国的首府。当时呢，卢昂是欧洲最富裕的城市之一，只是后来在中世纪时期，它受到了英国人的掌控。我们先来看三个单字 ，jewel 表示瑰宝、珍宝，那这个字也有宝石的意思。Jeff 老师刚刚提到几种宝石，像 ruby 表示红宝石，还有 sapphire。Sapphire 表示蓝宝石。 再来看下一个单词 cultural。Cultural 是形容文化的，跟文化有关的。Major 是形容主要的，比较重大的。它的相反词是 minor， 那就是形容次要的，比较小的。好，那么刚刚 Jeff 老师提到说，主要的贸易中心就意味着它有大量的商业交易活动。老师这时候用到 transact 这个动词 ，transact， transact 表示交易、办理或是处理。好，那这边还有一个重点，课文写到说 ，located not far from Paris on the River Seine, the city of Rouen is 怎么样怎么样？我们看到前半句它是用分词 located 开头的分词构句，我们就来学分词构句的用法。用对的连接词 and 去连接两个主词相同的子句时，我们可以省略 and， 再省略其中一句的主词，然后把该句的动词改分词。如果动词是主动，就用现在分词 ving， 被动就过去分词 pp。 例如 Beitou is located in the north of Taiwan and Beitou is famous for its hot springs。 北投位于北台湾，以温泉闻名。那前后子句的主词都是北投嘛，我们可以省略连接词 and， 再省略其中一个主词，像我们把前面的北投省略掉，然后把 be 动词改分词 being 通常可以省略，那就只保留后方的过去分词 located， 我们句子就会简化成 located in the north of Taiwan， Beitou is famous for its hot springs。 好，接回到课文中。
Rouen， France's jewel on the Seine。A good way to take in the city is to walk through Rouen's medieval quarter. Here, ancient half-timber houses line the streets, and pleasant cafes and shops surround its many squares. Enjoy lunch at La Couronne, France's oldest inn, and try the Rouen duck, parts of a duck served in a sauce made from its blood.
Okay, let's say you go to Rouen.
Okay.
What is the best way to experience this particular city? You might be asking yourself this question. Well, a good way to take in the city is to walk through Rouen's medieval quarter. So there you go. Remember, Rouen is very, very old, so it actually does have a medieval quarter, a part of that town that dates back to medieval times, or the Middle Ages, that's what they refer to.
Yeah, around 1,000 to 1,500 or so. So think of knights and castles and that kind of stuff. And that's exactly what you would sort of see, or at least a city version of that time period, in the medieval quarter of Rouen. It describes it here. Ancient half-timber houses line the streets, and pleasant cafes and shops surround its many squares. So don't think of the big wide streets and sort of modern beautiful buildings that you might see in Paris. Think of winding narrow streets, these half-timber houses, probably stone on the bottom, and then wood on the second and third floors, and of course, pleasant little cafes and shops, and many little squares.
Squares,
these would be,
yeah.
Where the little markets
were. One quarter many squares, yeah.
There you go, yeah. So a lovely place to sort of travel back in time to medieval times. Now I'm feeling a little hungry. We've been walking around all morning in Rouen. I only had a baguette for breakfast. Where should we go for lunch, Jeff?
Oh, enjoy lunch at La Couronne.
La Couronne?
La Couronne. Oh. That's my best French accent, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Enjoy lunch there.
Yep.
Why? Because this is...basically an awesome place to eat. It's France's oldest inn. Wow. And when you're there, try the duck. Do the Rouen duck.
Ooh.
And what does this mean? Well, Rouen duck, we're talking about parts of a duck served in a sauce made from its blood. And
blood sauce.
Some people find that very super delicious. I don't
you
know.
You should try
I'll
some.
I'll try it, but
try it.
I've got a blood thing.
Yeah.
Anyways, let's talk about this word in with two N's.
Yeah, in with two N's. We're not talking about in and out. We're talking in like hotel. An inn is a simple hotel that we probably would find out in the countryside or in a small town or village. You wouldn't go downtown to that big, you know, 24 five-star hotel and call that an inn. No, that's a hotel or a luxury hotel. An inn, you'd think about, you know, sitting on a mountaintop or a hilltop in the middle of Switzerland or something like that. Down a country lane, there's a little inn, maybe a restaurant or a pub attached to it. So very small, very old style, maybe only 5 rooms and an old lady who's been working there for 75 years.
That's optional.
That's optional. But think of that kind of small countryside hotel, not a big hotel in a city. For example, Alex's aunt runs an inn in the countryside.
All right, folks, with that, it's time for us to take a break, but don't go away. We'll be back soon.
要游览卢王这个城市呢，课文建议我们说可以徒步穿梭它的中世纪区。那边的街道上可以看到一些房屋，它们的木架结构是裸露在外面的。那有许多广场的四周有咖啡简餐店和商店。那如果你肚子饿，你其实可以去皇冠餐厅来享用午餐，那是法国最老的旅馆。如果你敢吃鸭肉鸭血的话，你就可以试试看卢昂鸭。这道料理呢，是有部分的鸭肉会淋上鸭血做成的酱汁。好，这边有一个单字是 inn，它表示小旅馆。Mike 老师提到小旅馆，也许它可能是位于山顶上，旅馆里面还有阿桑，可能这边服务了几十年了。但是这不一定啊，不一定要有阿桑，不一定要具备这些条件才能成为小旅馆。老师们这时候用到 optional 这个字 ，optional 表示非必须的，或是可选择的，或是随意的。解法课文中。
Rouen, France's jewel on the Seine. While visiting the medieval quarter, be sure to check out the Gros Horloge. Dating back to the 1300s, the Pride of Rouen is one of the city's most photographed objects. It has 2 clock faces, each showing a golden sun casting 24 rays against a blue night sky.
Okay, so you're in the medieval quarter, okay? There's something there that you can't miss. There's a jewel within the jewel within a jewel. Yeah, Rouen's a jewel, then the medieval quarter's a jewel. And there's a jewel even within that jewel, the medieval quarter. And I can't pronounce it.
Are you talking about the duck with the blood sauce that's the jewel in my stomach?
That's also a jewel, but no. Talking about something that... in this next sentence that I just can't pronounce.
Okay,
it's really French.
It is kind of French, but there's a very simple meaning that everyone will soon get. It says, while visiting the medieval quarter, so in this same part of Rouen, while visiting the medieval quarter, be sure to check out the Gros Horloge. The Gros Horloge.
You mean just something really big?
Say it like that. Yeah, Gros is big and Horloge is clock. So it's the big clock.
Check out the big clock,
everybody. Check out the big clock.
That
I can't
pronounce.
We're not talking about Big Ben in London. We're talking about a big clock in Rouen, and much older than the clock on Big Ben there in London, dating back to the 1300s.
Wow.
It's an old clock, too. Not only is it big. Dating back to the 1300s, the pride of Rouen is one of the city's most photographed objects. So it's from the medieval times. 1300s is right there in the medieval times. To talk about something as the pride of a place, it's something the local people are proud of. They know it makes their city famous. They know the tourists come to see it. And they're like, yeah, we got a big clock. It's pretty special. Most places don't have it. You might say that Taipei 101 is the pride of Taipei. Mm. You don't walk around going, I'm so proud of it. But you know it's something that makes your place famous.
It fills you with pride.
Well, maybe.
Yeah. Maybe. Okay, let's go ahead and learn some more about this Gros Horloge.
The
big clock. It has 2 clock faces, each showing a golden sun casting 24 rays against a blue night sky.
It's a pretty clock, too.
It sounds very pretty. Now, here we have the verb cast to talk about. If you cast something, for the most part, you throw that thing. But normally, when we're talking about casting something, we're talking about throwing that in a particular way. Or when we're talking about throwing light on something, throwing light on the surface of something. For example, the fire cast an orange light on the walls of the cave. There you go. Light is being let off or thrown by this fire. It's being cast by this fire. All right, folks, that's it for day one of our article, but stay tuned. We'll have part two for you next time.
来到卢昂的中世纪区，一定要去看看大钟楼，那可是卢昂的骄傲。那么大钟楼有两个钟面，每一面都会展现出在蓝色夜空衬托之下投射出24道光芒的金色太阳。好，单字 cast 在这边表示投射，它是当动词，那动词三态同形。我们最后来看一个重点是，课文有写到 It has two clock facesEach showing 什么什么，其中的 each showing 就是由 and each shows 简化而来，那就是独立分词构句的方法。诶，我们刚刚学到分词构句，那其实分词构句跟独立分词构句都是省略连接词，并且把其中一个动词改分词的结构，差别在于当前后的主词相同，我们省略了其中一个主词，这称为分词构句。当前后主词不同，我们都要保留这两个主词，那就会变成独立分词构句。举例来说， The man shouted and his eyes flashed with anger. 那名男子大叫，眼中冒出怒火。由于前后主词不同嘛，一个是男子，一个是他的眼睛，当然这两个主词都必须保留。那我们接着就省略连接词 and， 再把后半句的动词 flashed 改成现在分词 flashing， 那句子就会简化成 The man shouted, his eyes flashing with anger. 好，以上是今天的讲解，同学别走开，马上回来哦。
Hello， 各位同学，大家好，我是吉安老师。我们来看一下今天的简短独白，来介绍跟引言继续来练习。第一题 ，Why was Mary McGoddard invited to the event？ 为什么她被邀请来这个 event 这个活动？Because she helped them get money， 因为她帮他们筹钱。Because she created the company， 公司是她创的。C， because she bought a special ticket。最后 ，because the event is for her， 因为这个是为她办的哦。来，我们看第二个 ，What does the man mean when he says why we would not be where we are today without her？ 哦，我们今天呢能够有如此的成就，都是因为她，归功于她。所以你看哦，这一句话，你会不会觉得 Mary 她是一个重要的人啊 ？OK， 所以呢 ，A、B、C、D 是不是其实都有可能，对不对？C 可能就可以删掉，对不对 ？She bought a special ticket， 她买了票，所以她可以进来。没有，这不是你对待 VIP 的方式哦。VIP 就是完全不用买票就可以进来的。来，我们看一下 ，She had the original idea for the project。哦，这个案子的原创原来的想法是她的。Mary was a major part of their success。哦，这有可能啦，哦，就是他们成功有一大部分要归功于她。C. Mary personally founded the entire project. 整个企划案都是他募资的。OK， 他筹钱的，他资助的。最后一个 ，Mary was a key developer of the app. 他是这个应用程式的主要开发人。最后 ，What is mentioned about Mary? OK， she is an engineer. She has a disability. 她身体有不方便的地方。Disability 我们一般就是所谓身心障碍朋友了，那他是一个比较有礼貌一点点的说法。 C. She is the president of the company. 最后 She is going to make an announcement. OK， 他要讲话，来我们来听一下。
Good evening ladies and gentlemen. Our keynote speaker is about to take the stage. Many of you know Mary McGoddard is the star of the television show Into the Beyond.But perhaps fewer of you know that she has been a long-time supporter of technology for people with a disability. In fact, Mary helped secure the original funding that helped us build and develop our app. Make no mistake, we would not be where we are today without her. Mary is here tonight to talk about some of the issues she and other people with disabilities face on a day-to-day basis. Let's welcome her and give her a big round of applause.
刚刚大家都有抓到这三题呢是 ABB， 你如果有些看过题目的话呢，在听的时候就会比较容易听到重点。
Gentlemen, our keynote speaker is about to take the stage.
Keynote speaker 是主讲人哦。 Keynote
Many of you know Mary McGoddard is the star of the television show Into the Beyond. But perhaps fewer of you know that she has been a long time supporter of technology for
She's a long time supporter for technology OK， 它一直在支持这样的一种科技啊。
For people with a disability，
然后 for people with a disability， 然后这个身体不方便的人，它有一直在支持这样的科技。
In fact, Mary helped secure the original funding that helped us build and develop our app.
Okay, in fact, Mary helped secure the original funding. 原来的这个资金哦，所以呢，第一题答案是 A 嘛 ，She helped them get money. 那第二题的句子还没有出来。
Make no mistake, we would not be where we are today without her.
We would not be where we are today without her. 嗯，就是这样啦。没有他，我们今天是走不到这边的，所以答案是 B 哦 ，major part of their success.
Mary is here tonight to talk about some of the issues she and other people with disabilities face on a day-to-day basis.
All right, issues she and other people with disability. 他还有其他那些身体有障碍的人哈、哦，所以呢，第三题答案是 B. She has a disability. OK.好，我们来看一下这边整个架构、哦、我们要注意的就是说在阅读里面或者是听力里面也好，我们所谓的这种转折语、哦、通常后面都会有重点、高中的阅读其实也是这个样子、哦、你如果看到 however 啦，你看到 in fact 这一种语气的转折，它不管是想要加强或者是说要讲带出一个新的不同的东西的立场，那它后面通常会有重要的资讯。所以你看到这边啊、哦，In fact, Mary helped secure the original funding. 所以这边第一题的答案就跑出来，对不对 ？OK， 好。而且呢，你看到这边 ，But perhaps few of you know， 你们比较少人知道这件事情。他一直什么 ，long time supporter of technology for people with a disability. OK， 所以这边你就可以慢慢进入这样的一个状况。然后再来，你看啊、哦、，Make no mistake， 这边这样也是一个转折语嘛，哎。你们要搞清楚哦 ，We would not be where we are today without her. 没有她就没有我们 ，OK? She's here tonight. 哒哒哒。然后后面这边 ，She and other people with disabilities face on a day-to-day basis. OK? 好，所以呢，这三题的答案就清楚了。以上是我们今天的课程内容。我是季安老师，我们下堂课见，拜拜。
I can't believe how fast the time has passed by. Wow, we sure had a great time today.
Hope you can join us again for live interactive English.
See you next time.